Sometimes you feel like a nut.
Hey, all little farmers. Welcome back to Ravenport. As you can see, I'm spreading some fertilizer on a grass field. And once we get done, head right behind us, get to our canola field. It is canola. Yeah, canola. And we'll spread some fertilizer on that. And then head back to the chicken farm. And we'll dump out the fertilizer we have left. And we got to spread some lime down on those fields. And it looks like this time when I fertilize it, I got the spread pretty decent. Not too bad. So, in between episodes, a few things have happened. One, the grass has been compacted 100% and is now being fermented. Two, it is just recent for me, but I'm recording this a couple days in advance. Stevie's mod pack came out with all the utilities, some of the utilities I've been using. So you can see the John Deere probably over by the fillers over down there with our seed drill. If you remember, the seed drill wouldn't fill up with seed. It now does. So his mod pack has updates and some new implements you can use, whatnot. But he has a mod pack out there. You can find it on his Facebook page. Best place to get the download link, I think. But yeah, it's great that the seed drill now fills up by that mod from the silo. So I don't have to buy bags and bags from the store, which is great. The other thing I've also checked on is the BGA. Apparently, in patch 1.2, a lot of people are complaining about the BGA prices sucking terribly. I was in the discussion forum and I can see a lot of people are saying, yeah, they've had it with the BGA. They're actually selling the BGA that they have bought because they're selling all the silage and the price is just terrible. So I'm hoping that will be fixed in a patch, which Giant said they would like to have out by Christmas, which is basically a week from now. So right now I'll keep the BGA and all that and just sell the silage for what it is, I guess. Yeah, the price isn't the greatest. It's still not. I mean, if you consider it to the barn, I've seen the barn prices for silage be equal to that, so it's not that bad. But as far as I'm understanding, the BGA prices are supposed to be better than the barn because you got to buy the land to use it. So yeah, that's why I kind of saved up for it. But now we have the BGA, I don't really want to sell it because I'm expecting in the patch that that'll be fixed, hopefully. And like I said, you know, hopefully pretty soon, hopefully before my silage is ready to sell. I'm recording this late on a Saturday night. I just got home. So I'm hoping we'll wake up in the morning. There might be, you know, who knows, there might be an update. I don't know. But that's what I'm hoping for. Because, I mean, we got some silage. I mean, that grass over there won't be ready now for a day and a half-ish. Or 2 days, if hot, depending on how we look at it. So, yeah, we'll have to figure something out. I mean, either I have to sell the silage that we got in one bay, which is, like, just under 400,000 liters. I'd probably sell that one, because the other one's got, like, 520-something thousand. I forgot now. But let's focus on the task at hand for today. The two fields that we own over here, we're fertilizing, and then we're just waiting for them to ready to be harvested. I do have to keep an eye on this field, because this field, if you remember, had the weeds in it. And then the John Deere sowed the canola right over them, because I couldn't get rid of them. I was using the weeder, and they just wouldn't go. And they weren't the full-grown weeds, they were the first-stage weeds, so the weeder should have worked. I guess I could have tried using a herbicide, but I said, you know what, I'll just seed it into the ground. We'll see what happens. And then, like I said, we got to go to the chicken farm. We got to spread some lime down. Those three fields need some lime. And then we'll come back up here, grab the John Deere and the updated horse seed drill from Stevie. And, yeah, we're going to plant oats everywhere in those three fields. Start building up some oats. Start building up some oats a little bit. Put that in the silo so our 16 horses would be good. Yeah, in about, I think we're down to six or seven more days for the horses to be sold. And we'll get like $750,000. I'm still looking for a decent semi-truck out there. If I don't find one that I like, I'll probably get the man truck. Or M-A-N. I've heard that pronounced a lot of different ways. Some people just say M-A-N. Some people say man. I don't know. But I do like the cab overs just because their turning radius is better. The American trucks. And I say, I know this is weird because I am from America. But the American trucks, they're just longer. Harder to get in the tighter spaces. Harder to get in, you know, make some turns and whatevers. So right now I'm thinking the man truck is what we might be going with. Just so we can, transport the horses around. I don't want to keep paying transportation fees. And two, hopefully soon, because I kind of forgot to mention last episode I recorded, but the autoloaders are starting to come out. There was a autoloading baling trailer for... They're separate ones, so it's not all in one. You had to buy the specific one for round and the specific one for square. So some of the autoloading stuff is starting to get out there. So I've been keeping my eyes on a trailer that does pallets for the sheep's wool. Yes, I'm getting kind of lazy. I don't want to keep having to use the pallet fork on the Massey Ferguson to load the pallets up. But yes, mods are starting to come a little bit faster and faster. I'm still looking for a decent map. I mean, there's a lot of maps out there with different names, and it's just Ravenport or Fellsburn redone over different ways and whatnot. I'm looking for that unique map. But a good unique map is not going to come out as fast as some people would like to think. They do take time to create, obviously test it. No one wants, you know, there's probably are some maps out there, but I've seen some on the mod hub. I'm like, oh, that map looks good. And you see the pictures. Oh, it's not bad. And you see the comments below, like, loaded with errors. They one map. I'm like, oh, that looks pretty good. And the guy, in a couple of my, I fell through the map in two different locations. I'm like, oh, I may not want to do that map. Don't even bother. But the thing that's getting me right now is I'm hoping that my BGA prices go up. That's what I'm hoping for. When we bought it, it was at 500. And the price dropped to 360 and has been pretty much stagnant ever since. So our canola field and grass field, we'll take a quick peek at them. Oh, wait a minute. I got to turn grass on. Why? So it's not even grown yet, but that's fine. So we can see they're double fertilized. You don't need lime. But if you come down here, these three fields need lime. Lime ASAP. I am keeping an eye on field 12. It's still got corn in it. Oh, look at that job. 54,000. It's got to be potato. Yeah, potatoes or sugar beet. No thanks. So yeah, field 12 is one we're keeping our eye on. So now we're kind of saving some money up. You can see, well, it's kind of hard to see. Let me get the money down. Right now, I can have just under 92 grand in the bank account. The loan is maxed, and that's all I have for cash. Every time just before midnight, I do repay off the loan. So when midnight comes, I don't get hit with too much of an interest rate, but you know. And then once midnight passes, I take all the money back out just so I can buy seed and fertilizer and whatnot. But this field here with the corn in it, I'm keeping my eye on that. I don't want to do the job of harvesting corn just yet and all that. I want to give that field plenty of time so I can earn the money. So next time, hopefully it's a good crop in that field. that we can buy it, and we'll have these three fields here, and then we'll start saving up for a harvester and whatnot. But usually by then, with the, you know, selling the horses for $750,000, that should buy a harvester, I would think. But right now, I'm headed to the chicken farm. We'll unload this, fill this up with lime like 30 times, and lime those fields. All right, so I brought the John Deere down here with the seed drill. And looks like our Massey Ferguson did fill up. One thing I might do, though, I'm trying to start the engine. There we go. Is I want to repair this, because if I last I checked, the condition on it sucked. And I don't know if it's going to waste more lime and fertilizer. Yeah, see, the condition is terrible. Repair it for 400. I really wish the wouldn't repaint the vehicle, but you know, it is what it is. Maybe the Giants can change that. Maybe they can make a painting a separate category. I don't mind, I like the repairing aspect of it, but I wish that the paint would just kind of stay worn on it. Just my preference. So let's burn through this lime. Now, one thing I did notice in Stevie's mod pack that he has, the other Breedle, the bigger Breedle that he has, the working speed is 18 miles an hour rather than just 8. So it actually might use less lime and fertilizer because you're traveling faster. So you'll cover more area, and the spread might, he'll cover more area for what it's spreading. So I would assume you'd use a lot less lime / fertilizer in it. Something I will keep in my mind on. But obviously that's just more money, and right now, being money, I tend to spend it as soon as I get it. I'm even sitting here thinking $90,000, I could buy a few things with $90,000 for upgrades for the farm. But right now, I think we really need another field, because really, yes, we got the grass field, we got the field 6, but I need another field of income, because these three fields here, they're feeding our animals, which does bring us income. But not enough. Not enough. And yes, lime is cheap, so I'm going to actually spread and make sure I get that little piece there. I'm actually going to get the whole field this time. Even the pieces I have missed. Because it does annoy me just a little bit when I check the map and I see these little spots. There we go. Now I'm going to fold this up. And it's not going to hurt to refill it. And while this is refilling, that filled awfully quick. Alright, we are on oats, which is good, because we need oats. Well, the horses need oats. I personally don't. If I'm having oats, it better be brown sugar. Alright, we'll hire a helper. I'm not blocking him. He's fine. He's fine. And there we go. We're getting an oat field. It has fertilizer in it. Wait, you did not finish filling. Oh, you filled the bucket. Are you serious? This is why you can't leave the bucket on when you're doing other stuff, Peanut, because it does things like that. I'm like, I heard it filled and it said $100. I'm like, really? I use more lime than that. No, don't spill any in the ground. Did I spill any ground? Of course I did. Now it's going to bug me. We got to pick that up. All 18 liters of it. All right, you know what? I'm just going to drop this off. I'm probably going to forget where I put it, but this is a good spot. It's nice out of the way. And now I don't have to deal with it. I'm trying to fill up. I had the same problem. I left it on when I was harvesting. And the harvester was trying to put some seed into the bucket. And I was like, no. Oh, that was close enough to do that. All right. Our John Deere's already making quick work of it. Well, it's, I mean, they're small fields, yes. But he's making quick work of it. So I better make quick work of this field over here. Almost seems just about right, putting some lime on these fields, making it look like Christmas. I thought about making this field bigger by cutting down some trees and plowing a new field, if you will. Maybe in the future, but usually in the future, I already know what's going to happen is I'm just going to buy bigger fields and I'm not going to worry about these fields as much. It's like I said, they're just here to really kind of just feed our animals. But who knows, maybe in the future I'll have more chicken pens down here. Because everyone's waiting for that mod that someone's going to come out with an auto loader for the chicken boxes. That's what we're all waiting for, isn't it? Alright, one more field to lime. Yeah, so getting the bigger Breedle and doing a working speed of 18 miles an hour, I may not go through as much lime slash fertilizer. So something we'll have to look into. Plus, it'll hold more. I kind of like spreading lime on a field for some reason. I don't know why. It appeals to my eye. It passes the eye exam. This field here is a little weird. I'll cover the whole field, but when you go look at the map, it'll show strips that I've missed. I don't know, because I create a field here or it's just a map thing through Giants. I don't know. And I'm still wondering about the periodic plowing thing. I'm not sure I quite get what's going on there. Because I have harvested these fields more than three times and I've yet to plow them. Well, we have finished spreading some lime at the right time because I'm out. And I don't think I'm going to worry about those little sections there. I'm not going to let that bother me too much. He says until a day later he checks the map and those little lime spots will just drive him nuts. But also at the same time, our John Deere has finished doing what he's doing. I'm just going to refill our fertilizer spreader with fertilizer, because that seems about right. And hopefully that 2,000 fertilizer is enough to cover these three fields later on. Did you do a good job, sir? Did you actually get the whole field? Looks like he did. Looks like he did. I want to smooth this land out around the chicken area, but since the grass doesn't grow back just yet, I don't want to touch it. All right, we're getting more oats put into the ground. So meanwhile, we're just going to take a trip over the BGA. I'll turn on the HUD display so we can see. Like I said, this silage I'll probably sell. It's actually 3,600. And over here, that's right, we can't see. Does anyone remember? I want to say 520,000. But you can see it actually flattened out pretty nice. And once again, I didn't get stuck anywhere at all. This kind of disappointed me that I let some come up too far. But if we go to the page, I'm pretty sure silage, since I last checked it, has not moved. Stuck right at 360. It needs to move. It needs to move. The yarn. The wool is still at the same price. I probably should be selling some of that. And other than that, we can't sell too much. The price of canola was going up and looks like it might have went down overnight, but hopefully it gets up to above 1500. That'd be great, because the next day that field will be ready and we have no idea how much slurry we got, but not slurry, digestate, because there's no meter there. But we don't have that much yet. I think I've only putting in like 40,000 liters of silage, so we're not gonna have too much. And the reason why I hire workers is because we all know how I drive. I can't keep a straight line. And plus, it allows us to do other things while this guy is just going right to town. I mean, he's going to be done with that field pretty darn quick. Looks like I should be doing some cleaning up. Cleaning up in aisle 7. They're still not bad. So we should get some more sheep again today. So that'll be 16 new sheep that we have gotten since we purchased them, which means they'll just slowly keep producing wool faster and faster and faster. And if you wonder about our horses, I mean, heck, I can even sell the horses now and get a good penny for them. But let's not do that. Let's wait until they're fully trained. Right, ladies? Right, ponies? So I'm going to watch this guy get to work, and I'll bring it back in just a little while. One more strip to go, which we are doing ourselves because, I don't know, the AI helpers, when it gets down like the end of the field, they don't seem to want to do the rest of the entire field for some reason. I have no idea. Maybe it's a union thing. I have no idea. But now we got 3 fields of oats. Hopefully it'll keep our horses happy. I think if I do this 2 or 3 more times, we can keep up with the horses per se just by doing oats in that field and maybe wheat in that field for the chickens. But the John Deere and the seed drill need to go back up to the BGA. Because really, that's where they'll be needed the most next. Field 6, obviously, as you saw, that crop is already growing. So that'll be harvested next, and that'll be seeded next. I would like to do some plowing of my fields, but I mean, I guess I could do it just for the funsies, but they don't require it. Like I said, maybe in the update coming up, hopefully sometime soon, that's addressed as well. I'm pretty sure you just don't need to plow it one time and that's it. You should be doing it every 3 harvest. That's why we have that setting. That's why it's on. Any traffic coming? Nope. Actually, I'll go this way. And then this way. Oh, since we're going right past here. So now that I can show you, as if he didn't believe me, we'll stroll right up to the silo. We'll open up the seed drill. And you can see we got 7,800 liters of seed. And you can see now it fills right up. And since I'm here with this top off, spend more money. Gotta spend a little money today, right? Yeah, we spend it on lime and whatnot. So all of our fields are pretty much set to go, other than I gotta fertilize the ones down by the chicken farm once again. Oh, the bay door is wide open for us. It's almost like it knew. Yeah, once again, I'm glad I bought the biggest garage, because at first I was like, nah, we can just get by with this or that. And I'm using like every bay door there is. Anything, what did I take out of, oh, that's the belt that's in the BGA. No, that's the wrong pedal too, Peanut. You're doing just great here. Need to park our equipment away. Not close enough? There we go. But before we do, give our shooter maker a nice clean, nice wash. This was well worth the money, holding 90,000 liters, and it picks up really fast. One thing I do like about a lot of Stevie's mods is everything is not repaintable. You can paint it whatever color it is, even though I think even it has a John Deere in there. It might be the 8AR series that you can paint any color. Of course, some people out there will be like, you do not do that. We play games to have fun. If some people want to do that, he's been requested enough where people would like to have that done. So I try not to paint some equipment. I like keeping the factory colors sometimes, but it got to the point, as you saw, everything on my farm was red. I'm going to close that up. And the John Deere will kind of sit outside, I guess. I mean, I do have room to park it in there, but I might need it for something, for a job. Actually, while we're sitting in the John Deere, and we can actually kind of speed up time instead of on times one. I'll put it at times 30 for now. I think I'll park it over by field 12 over here just to see what, you know, keep an eye on it. And keep an eye on our field as well. But this farmer has some ups. Yeah, so if you go in here, is it, or was it the 6R? It might be the 6R. 6R series by Stevie. So if we come in here, there's the John Deere, and we can change it to an orange John Deere, purple John Deere, black edition if you want, rim color. Yeah, you can do a whole sorts of things. So he's got the 6R. Other things he has in his mod pack. Does he have anything for the these planters here? Oh, no, because he wouldn't, because the horse does mostly everything. But like the tether we have, he made a mod for the tether. So our tether, it's the same thing. The only difference is the working speed, the one we have is 11. His is 16. But the one thing I would like to get, because we use it a lot, is a fertilizing technology. So yes, it's even a little cheaper, but you can see, whoops, this one does at 12. This one does at 16. Which is really nice. I think you'll just use less and less fertilizer that way. But I think that's going to do it for today, guys. I'm going to sit here and just watch this field and see what happens with it. no, just kidding. Yeah. So hopefully when this field gets taken care of, they put something in there that we can harvest. That'd be really nice. Well, first of all, I got to get the money to buy it, right? And maybe the price of the BGA will go up. If the price of the BGA goes up, that was going to be very close to where we can buy the field. Because we almost have 900,000 liters of silage to sell. Like I said, that's going to do it for today, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. I appreciate you watching, as always. And I'll see you next time in Ravenport. But until then, have a good one.